Hey everyone, Rodney here at Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to show you how to create scenes with different characters and not have them all mixed up. Normally when you try to generate more than one person in a scene, the AI will get the details mixed up. You'll have a woman that's bald, a guy with long hair, but with a few simple techniques you can get scenes with multiple characters that make sense. Now in this video I will be using in-painting and image prompts, so I do recommend being familiar with those tools, and I do have videos that cover those and many other topics. Okay, so let's get started. So in Fooocus, we're gonna have this set up. I'm gonna go onto the speed setting. I'm gonna set my resolution 1344x768. Styles, I don't need these. We're gonna go with comic book and semi-realistic and V2. Now onto the model, I'm gonna change this and use the Cheyenne one. That's this one here. I've been finding this one to be a pretty good, interesting model overall. And now in the advanced area, we're gonna check off developer debug mode and go to the control tab. And then we wanna check off image prompt and inpaint. And now I'll put this under the control inpaint tab. We can leave it there. Now at the bottom, you wanna check off input image at the below here. And then in the image prompt area, you wanna go down to the bottom and check off advanced. So we have all the controls. I've already gone ahead and gotten my pose. I do have a video that covers the Pose My Art website. That would be this one here. It's a couple videos back. I do recommend checking that out. I'm not gonna cover all the stuff about that. But once you, if you wanna use that, you can get your pose. You find what you're looking for. You get the angle you want. You go to export. You set your height and width. And then you click on the export image and get the image that you want. At this point, I have my pose that I want. So we're going to put that in here. I'm going to change this over to CPDS because I find that usually works best for this. And now at this point, we're pretty much ready to go. Now I could go ahead and put a whole prompt in here on what I want. And I am going to do that initially just to get things going. What happens is a lot of these things end up getting mixed up. And so when we go ahead and generate it, we end up with something that we don't want. And this is the issue. You end up with one character is different than the other. Different parts of the scene are different because of the colors that you put in. And it just makes it very difficult. And you can keep on generating and trying to get what you want. But a lot of times you'll never get what you want. And even with a lot of inpainting, it can be a lot of work. So as we can see here, we have a female superhero in a green outfit, a green and black outfit. That actually worked. It's got a gold star on it. But now I got all these gold stars in the background. This is not a male villain in black completely. It's the same outfit. And there's the influence of the green colors in the background and everything. So that's where this comes into being a problem and what we want to get around. So we're going to stop this because I don't want any of that stuff. I'm just going to put a female superhero and that's it. Nothing else. It's all the detail I need. Kicking a male villain backwards, and that's all I'm going to put in here. And I'm going to put in a back alley and nothing else. Now, if I wanted to describe, this is where I'd want to describe the scene more, because that's where you can change the background and everything else, because we're going to work on the characters. Those aren't as important at the moment. When you're first setting this up, you want to just get that scene, the background of what you're looking for. So we're going to go ahead. I'm not too picky for this image, so we're just going to generate that. Okay, so I'm going to stop this because I'm happy with that one for right now. I don't like these two, but well, I'm going to see what this one comes out as. Nah, I like this one, so we're going to go ahead with this one. There we go. So now you say, well, we don't have the characters we want, but that's what we're going to work on next. Now that we have the one that we like, and I'm going to use this one because I don't have all this the wind or this fire, because I don't want that in there at the moment. So we're gonna go to inpaint or outpaint. I'm gonna take this one, we're gonna drag that one down. So now we have our base to start with. In order to get these poses to stay, and I do talk about this in one of my last videos about the text, and that comes down to this inpaint respective field. What happens is if we leave this now and we were to inpaint this, it won't maintain that pose because it's not gonna use that whole image to do the inpainting. It will crop it down and only use a portion of it. And that's not gonna work for us on how we're doing this. There is ways of doing that, but we're gonna stick with the simple method here. So what we need to change is this inpaint respective field. because we want to tell it, instead of only working with a portion of the image, as it's going to do now, if we were to mask an area, it's only going to zoom in on that area and work on that, which in most cases is the preferred way of doing it because you're not trying to maintain a pose. But in this one, we want to maintain that same pose, that structure from this image. So in order to do that, we need to change this in-paint respective field all the way to 1, which tells it to use completely the whole picture for that reference. Now we can go ahead and in-paint what we want to replace. So the first one is we're going to want to replace one character at a time. You don't want to do too much. That's the key thing when it comes to this. You work on one section, one description at a time. You do want to overlap these a little bit because it's not always going to hold the exact same pose. And okay, I can remove some of this. And my spell check isn't even going to fix that. Okay, so a female superhero in a green and black outfit kicking. That's really all I need here. But if I want to add more, I could. That's entirely up to you. The other thing you could do as well is if you already have a design that you want to get similar to, you can use that in the image prompt. Now, I'm not going to be trying to get this perfect, just to warn you of that. This is just to show you how it can be done. Now we can crank, I don't need to crank that all the way up. Well, we're going to keep these on both 1. There we go. So that's telling it we want to influence it all the way through and very heavily with the weight. Now, it's still not going to get it correct, but it'll get it pretty close. And then we could go through and in-paint it. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to try to get these perfect, but you could do that. Now that we're all set here, I've gone ahead. I've changed my in-paint respective field. So let's go ahead and generate and see if we can change that character on the left. Okay, so we have our scene, our first character. So let's see which one more closely matches, because that's the one I'm going to go with. Some they get the boots right, some they get the other stuff right. So we're going to go with this one here. Yeah, that one works fine. Okay, so we have our first character done. Obviously, if I was picky and I wanted to get those better, I could work on more in-painting just certain sections of the image. At that point, I could go through and let's say if the boots weren't exactly how I want, I could try to work on those. Do keep in mind, if you start doing the in-painting, if you want to keep that pose exact, you do need to use the in-paint respective field at 1, and you do need to keep that in the image prompt. Now, we do want to remove this because we're going to be now doing the next character, and we don't want to influence that. But we do want to leave that image prompt in there because we want to keep the pose going. So at this point, let's bring down the new image. And we will now in-paint this character. Okay. And we have everything else all set. So we're going to go ahead and generate. Now we could do the same thing if we wanted to, put something in the image prompt to influence that. But for this one, we're not going to do that. Okay, so now we have our second character into the scene. I've kept things pretty simple, but you could go however you want with this. So I'm gonna go with this one. So now I'd be happy with that. I'll bring that down to the in-paint area. I'm gonna clear that. So we now have our two distinct characters in the scene fighting it out. So that's really how you get two distinct characters separately in a scene, is you work on first, I find the scene, and then you can generate at that point. Now, you could, in theory, generate the background completely first without using the pose and then bring that in and try to line things up and draw on it. But I find it's best just to start off with that, and then you can just replace the characters, give them very generic information, describe the background, and then you can replace the characters. Okay, so we have our image, but now we want to have action text. This is kind of boring without it. So let's go ahead and create some. So we're going to mask off an area here. And we could go ahead and just prompt it in. That's one way of doing it. And hopefully it gets what we want. That's always a possibility. But I'm going to show you a different way. This is the way that I did my last video with text somewhat. So we have our area that we're going to have masked off. And we're going to leave the in-paint respective field as it was, because we do want to work with this whole image. Then I'll go on to any place that does background removal. I'm gonna take the image that I last generated and we just drop it in. I'm gonna remove the background, then I'll go ahead and I'll download it. And which I've already done once, but so we'll go ahead and download that image. Now, then I just go into Adobe Express or any other image editor. Now the big thing here is I'm using the same resolution as the image. That's important. I will then bring in my image here. Okay, there we go. Now it's centered. So now we have our centered image, and then let's go with POW. And I'll bring that in, put it at a slight angle. And then let's see, we're gonna change this text. Okay, now we have our text. I can remove these guys because I don't want them. And then we're gonna just go ahead and download. And now, once we have our image, we go into the image prompt. We're gonna drag that in. And for this one, I'm gonna use Pyrocani. You could use CBDS, use whichever one works. It's hit or miss depending on these. Sometimes one works better than the other. So I find it's just use whichever one you find works best for this. We probably don't need it to be a really high stop at because those are bold letters. Now we can go ahead in here and I'll add in a prompt, the word POW in yellow, comic book action word. Let's go ahead and generate. And there we go. We have our action words. Some of these don't come out the greatest, and sometimes it takes a little bit of trial and error. You can change how the prompt is. As I said, you could try just getting it without using the image prompt as I did, but I just find that that usually ended up working better. But if not, you can do it either way. That should help you create more complex scenes with different characters much better using Fooocus. Now hopefully you found this video helpful and would consider hitting that like button or even buying me a coffee. I do want to thank the people who have donated since it really does help out a lot. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.